Well, let's speak to the Stop HS2 campaign manager, Joe Rukin. He joins us via Skype from Kenilworth in Warwickshire. I mean, you're involved in an 11-day walk of the proposed route, I think, of HS2 with your dog, Evie. Well, first of all, we'll talk about what I've just heard. Let's talk about how you think this leaves HS2 now.
Well, we've been lied to. We've been lied to consistently in a calculated manner for 3 years now. Not just the public, but MPs and Parliament have been deliberately misled. You've got to remember that these revelations, this letter from Patrick McLaughlin to George Osborne, obviously that shows it's a long time ago, but this is before the final vote on HS2. And ever since then, we've had minister after minister saying HS2 is on time and on budget, and I thoroughly expect it to stay that way. And it has been a lie. They have been lying through their teeth, and they've known it. Everyone has been misled. This makes a mockery of the idea of having an executive that is accountable to a democratic parliament. It's ridiculous. They have just stuck two fingers up at democracy and said, no, you vote for it like good little boys and girls and leave the big grown-up decisions to us. That's how they've operated.
Well, I should point out that Grant Shapps has, as we've seen in the last week, said maybe it's time for a review of this. I mean, not all in government are doing what you're saying they're doing.
Oh, no, I'm saying that that's what's happened for the last 3 years. That's how we've got to this situation, where HS2 is basically, they've been allowed to get away with anything. And I think there's going to be more revelations to come as more and more whistleblowers come out, I feel. And this has the potential to be the scandal that keeps on giving if this project is not cancelled immediately. We're very dubious about the review, because obviously there's only a couple, Tony Barclay and Tony Travers are the two, you know, sceptics of HS2. Most people are dyed-in-the-wall pro-HS2 people. And it's quite disturbing that they said, oh, we need to reassess the economic benefits of the project, because that's what's historically always happened with HS2. Whenever it gets into trouble, they go back to the drawing board and they invent more economic benefits. They just pull them out of the air and say, oh, yeah, it'll be a land of milk and honey. It will do exactly the opposite of what every other high-speed railway line in the world has ever done. I suck more stuff to the capital. This is going to do exactly. It's going to be a magic wand to cure the North-South divide. And they just make stuff up. And if they've been prepared to lie to the public and Parliament for 3 years about the cost of the project, about the deliverability of the project, and about the timetable, then clearly they've been quite willing to lie about anything. You cannot trust a word that is said about this project.
Given the amount of money that's already been spent on it, the number of people who've had to move out of their homes and offices to make way for it, aren't we too far down the track, forgive the pun, to pull out?
No, absolutely not. Saying that $7 billion or so has been spent means that we've got to chuck another $100 billion at it. Plus, of course, all the additional costs for the hidden extras, you know, like things like electricity, the generation of it, and the way of getting it to the sites, and all the ways of plumbing it into the existing network. All that stuff is extra. And the reality is that it is a tragedy that people have been forced out of their houses. It is equally a tragedy that the destruction of irreplaceable habitats and ancient woodlands continues as we speak, when there's supposedly a yes-no review going on. But the reality is that a lot of the money that's been spent can be recovered. The property can be sold on. The land that has been cleared, the land around Euston, Old Oak Common and Curzon Street was always meant to be a cash cow that was going to help pay for the scheme. No one is saying, you know, recontaminate that land. You know, no one is saying stick the old buildings back. That land is still there for development and can provide a cash cow without having to blow all the money on HS2. So it could actually work out quite well in the end. But saying that, you know, we spent a bit means we've got to waste a lot more is just a ridiculous idea, Simon.
Joe, it's good to talk to you. Good. Is the walk over, or have you got a bit more to do?
No. I had a break today because I thought I'd be doing a load of interviews. I've done a few. but as soon as this is done, my sister is giving me a lift back to Middleton in North Warwickshire, and we'll be starting again. Hope to get in a few miles tonight before I camp down, and we'll continue onward.
Was the train too slow?
Well, there isn't a train there. This is a thing.
Joe, I'm being wicked. It's good to talk to you.
Thanks
for your time. Thanks. That's Joe Rukin.
Bye-bye.